Kia ora tātou. So, you're at home, feeling under the weather, with COVID. Your healthcare team will provide you with heaps of information about how to stay safe at home, including how to keep an eye on your symptoms and when to call for help. One of the things they might give you is a pulse oximeter. You may not have heard of these things before, so listen up, because using one might become part of your daily checks. A pulse oximeter uses a tiny light beam to measure oxygen levels in your blood cells and your pulse. On your pulse oximeter, your pulse, also known as your heart rate, is measured in heartbeats per minute, or PRBPM. Your oxygen levels are measured as a percentage and could show as SpO2% on the oximeter. COVID can cause your blood levels of oxygen to fall or your heart rate to get faster. These are signs that you might need help or you might need to call an ambulance. If you've been asked to use one, you'll need to use this 3 times a day until you've recovered from COVID. Understanding the readings is easy. A normal pulse for adults is between 50 and 99. A pulse of 100 to 119 means you need to tell your healthcare team, or GP, straight away. A pulse of 120 or more, you should call 111 for urgent care. Normal oxygen levels are 95 to 100%. For an oxygen reading of 92 to 94%, contact your healthcare team. An oxygen reading below 92% means you should call 111 for urgent care. Now, it's important to know the difference between the pulse and the oxygen readings. Don't mix these two up. Don't just rely on a pulse oximeter to work out your oxygen levels. You must also watch for these signs that must be reported immediately. Bluish colouring on your face, lips or nails, shortness of breath, difficulty breathing or a cough that gets worse, restlessness and discomfort, chest pain or tightness, fast or racing pulse. You're probably wondering how to use one of these things. Wash your hands and remove any nail polish or false nails. Rest for at least 5 minutes before taking the reading. If your hands are cold, warm them by rubbing them together. Your hand should be at waist level. Try resting your hand on a table or the arm of a chair. Make sure the batteries are inserted into the pulse oximeter and try to have a supply of new batteries handy. Switch the pulse oximeter on. The display will light up. Squeeze to open and put your finger in until it touches the end. It's best on the middle or index finger. If it doesn't work, try another finger. Keep your hand still for 1 to 2 minutes until your pulse reading is steady and your oxygen number has not changed for 5 seconds or more. If your numbers are not steady, try a different finger. Record both numbers to track any changes. Your pulse and oxygen level numbers are easy to mix up, so record them carefully. Keeping your diary up to date is really important, so your healthcare team knows what's going on. Measure and record your numbers 3 times a day at about the same time every day. You should take extra measurements if you feel a change in your health or your symptoms. There is a special pulse oximeter for our young ones. Now, most children with COVID won't need one and will only receive a child's pulse oximeter if they do. Children over 30 kg about 10 years or older, can use an adult pulse oximeter as long as their finger goes all the way to the end. Using an adult pulse oximeter on smaller children may give an inaccurate reading. So for children under 30 kg, that's most 9-year-olds or younger, such as Willow, they'll need a child's pulse oximeter. Prepare the oximeter and record as you do for adults, starting with hand washing and removing nail polish. For kids, oxygen levels are the same as adults. Remember, don't just rely on the pulse oximeter. Other symptoms of low oxygen levels that need to be reported immediately can be if your child has blue lips and tongue, has difficulty breathing, has episodes of irregular breathing or stopped breathing, is unconscious, or you can't wake them up properly. If at any time your child has trouble breathing, or the symptoms keep getting worse, you know what to do.
Call 111.
Tika. Pumarie.
Pumarie, Dad.